Welcome. What are we learning today? We're learning the difference between voltage and amperage. Let me show you what I've got. I have an excellent collection of DC motors. I call them excellent because they're of all sizes, from the tiny to the medium to the small to the extra large. I have all these DC motors. These are all from automotive light trucks, every single one of them. I bet you can recognize what this monster guy is. Okay, that one's an older one. This one represents a more common type. I bet you figured out what it is. These are all DC motors. Every single one of these is a DC motors, and the size is very, very well represented. This is the blower motor. This is a fuel pump motor. Anybody know what this one is? This is off an air conditioning ventilation actuator. This is an example. This is an example of how all of these, every single one of these, operates at the same voltage. Of these motors that I have to show you, operate at battery voltage. Now, unless you have an electric vehicle, all vehicles have batteries. This was going to represent our battery. It's nothing more than a booster pack. And I'm going to show you. That's my specialty. I don't just say it. I'm going to show you that all of these motors operate at 12 volts, but every single one of them operates at different amperage. I'm going to show you amperage from a very large amount to a medium amount to a small amount. Before we go on to the amps, make sure you understand every DC motor on the vehicle, whether it be the smallest to the biggest, operates at the same voltage. And who knows what the answer is? What voltage is that? Battery voltage. Put a number to it. 12 volts. I'm going to take a 12 volt booster pack. I'll move it to the side so it gives us room to work. I took a couple of jumpers and I connected it to my battery. Do I have electricity? Yes. Yes, I do. We already know that 12 volts is not going to electrocute us, but it will burn us. If I put this together, it's going to get red hot. I'm going to operate all of these devices. Are we ready? Let's start with the medium one. Okay, all of these are DC motors. All they need is a couple of wires. Operate it. But the most important thing that I want to show you is over here, right here. What I want to show you is the spark. You see that spark? Now, I'm not afraid of getting electrocuted. I am not. 12 volts will not electrocute you. But what I'm trying to show you, not just tell you, I am showing you, and we're going to measure, and I'm a good guesser, I bet you that's about 10 amps. How many volts is it? 12. How many amps is it? I'm a good guesser, and I'm going to measure there. You see the spark? Yes, you do. Let me show you a smaller motor. We started in the middle, and then we'll go down, and then we're going to go up. Okay, I have to be very careful with these two wires, these two jumpers. Now, I'm comfortable working with these, and so long as they don't touch, I'm fine. Let me go to a smaller motor. This is a fuel pump motor. This is the average size of a fuel pump in your automobiles and your light trucks. Now, you're not going to see anything, okay? But you will see the spark. And if I be quiet for a minute, I think you'll hear the motor. Oh yeah, you'll hear the motor. But I want you to pay attention to the spark. You see that? There. I really have to try. Anybody want to guess How many volts that is? That's the easy one. Who wants to guess at how many amps there is? Let's go that way. I'm going to jump a starter motor now. Let me make a little bit of room, because I'm going to need it. I'll better start off with the smaller one. Now I'm going to take an average size starter motor. Oh, you'll hear this one. But again, we're concentrating on the spark. You see that spark? Now you don't see me flinching. Now I'll tell you, it gets a little warm right here. Okay, you could easily burn yourself, but I don't want you to be afraid of getting electrocuted. This is a starter motor. This, what you see, is amperage. And yes, there's no question about it. This guy right in here, this one, this one, this one, all of them operate at the same voltage. What voltage is that? Battery voltage, 12 volts. Now it's time to measure amps. If you've ever taken any of my classes, you know I'm a measuring fool. I don't just say it, I show you. I am going to show you with this meter amperage. Now we got volts out of the way, yes? All of them, every single one of those motors operates at the same voltage. Is it hard to believe that that tiny little bitty motor operates at the same voltage as that huge starter? Anyway, here, let's take a couple of measurements. We're going to be concentrating on the red scale. Now, I'll zoom in, but it goes from 0 to 100. Let's take a couple of measurements. Right in here, this is a blower motor, and I told you that it takes about 10 amps. Let's measure it. Okay, don't take my word for it, right? Let's measure it. So, on that red scale, how many amps is that? Okay, you hear it? That is high speed. I think we were about 10 on the meter. Now, do you remember the spark? Let me remind you of the spark. You can see the spark. Okay, and I'm not afraid of getting electrocuted. It does get a little bit warm. Now, if maximum speed takes 10 amps, the other speeds take less. Okay, let's bump it up. Okay, let's move over a little bit. I'm going to measure, I'm a measuring fool. I'm going to measure the starter draw amps. We're still on the same scale. Okay, it's obvious that this guy uses more amperage than this guy. They all use the same amount. Here on the red scale, take a look. How many amps are we using this time? We're about halfway. We're at 57 amps. But not only is the needle important, right here, look at 57 amps. You see that? That's the difference between amps and volts. All of these motors and many electrical loads, all of them work at battery voltage. They all work at the same voltage. It's the amperage. If I measured this one, getting a little long, and I want to show you something else. This is going to use a very small amount. 1 amp, 2 amps. This one's going to use a few more amps. 5 amps, 6 amps. They're all 12 volts. This one, how much is this going to use? Trick question. Depends what speed it's on. You saw high speed. Who remembers? How many amps? High speed, 10. How many volts? Easy, 12. Can you guess the amps on low? 2 or 3 amps. That's it. Now, don't take my word for it. Let's take a couple of more measurements and then we'll wrap it up. Our next measurements are going to require that we use a smaller meter, a more sensitive one. We use this one to measure 10 amps, 50 amps, 60 amps. We showed you that. We're going to measure smaller amounts. So we're going to need a different meter. We're going to use this one. okay? Because it's capable of measuring a fraction of an amp, and that's where we're going. Let me get rid of this one and take you down to business. Come on. Here it is, right there. This is my smallest of all motors. Yes, and right here, I put a little piece of tape on there so you can tell that it's on. Now, back to the little spark. The motor is working. Can you see the spark right here? Can you see it? No, you can't, because it's a very, very small amount. Now, earlier, I guessed at 1 amp. I said 1 amp. Well, let's take a look at it. Let's measure it. I don't just tell you, I show you. All I need to do is take a nicer meter. And then I'm going to dial it in, I hope to the right spot. Okay, I'm going to turn this little guy on, and I'll show you the display, and I'll explain it a little bit, and then we'll bump it up and down just a little bit. What are we showing you? We're showing you amps. There it is. And all I have to do is put this around it, and hopefully you can see the display. All right. I can see it correctly. I am measuring the amperage of this actuator motor. It's a little bit over 1 amp. Okay, let's move on a little bit. Battery voltage. Battery voltage, it operates many things. Now there's only two other voltages. There's battery voltage, and we know that one. The 12 volts. There's electronics. We'll get to that several lessons down. And then there's only one more. If you have a gasoline engine, that would be the ignition voltage, high secondary voltage. Folks, if you liked our video, please keep hitting that like button. Folks, if you learned something, keep hitting that notice bell. And the most important thing of all, if you had a little fun while you learned, hopefully we can keep coming around. Hit that subscription button. Thank you for the view.